So now you know that humanity keeps striving to improve their current ledger. And as mentioned, ledger evolve, society evolves. But in our strive towards a perfect ledger, we first, of course, need to define what a perfect ledger is. So there are some very interesting articles. You can find them in the further reading, which gives some properties. Bottom line, properties of a perfect ledger. Bottom line here is that a perfect ledger has no transaction costs. So what does this mean? Basically, a friction or a wall or a slow motion or something that you need to pay, a cost between transferring value from A to person B. So what does this mean? It should be instantly. So, for example, if we take the example where you are on the sidelines recording your friends, of course, there is not only a moment in time, because you first need to witness this and then you need to record it, but also because you are doing this in your own, you can make errors, you can get coerced, you can cook the books, whatever you want. Like, there are multiple risks there as well. So there are some, let me rephrase that. It isn't perfect. It isn't a perfect ledger. So what is a perfect ledger? A perfect ledger mimics the real world as best as possible, or not as best as possible. It mimics the real world. So let me rephrase that one. A perfect ledger equals the real world. So transactions are instant, for example. There are no intermediaries recording transactions, etc., etc. So basically, there are no thresholds, so no costs to do a transaction. And while we've been continuously growing towards that perfect ledger, so for example, it's currently lighter. So let's say this is way lighter than a big heavy clay tablet. I can record more things on this as well as on a clay tablet. I can make it digital, I can transfer it, et cetera, right? You see where I'm going. But of course, this is not a perfect ledger. So while we keep on moving and keep on improving towards that final goal, zero transactional costs, we keep letting society grow with it. So in the next slide, you can see an overview of the perfect ledger with the properties. I suggest you should read that on your own. I think you now have a decent idea of what we strive towards to a perfect ledger. Keep in mind, of course, that a blockchain is not a perfect ledger, but it's just another step towards that perfection. Right? See you next one.